Wolf, 1994. Starring Jack Nicholson in this iconic must-see werewolf flick. The movie opens up where we see a car driving down a long and winding road. And wouldn't you know, the car is being driven by none other than the iconic, legendary, one and only Jack Nicholson. Or Will Randall. He's just cruising along when this happens. He gets out to check on the wolf, but just ends up getting the fuck bitten out of him. And you know what that means. When he goes to get up and run away, he sees a pack of wolves just lurking in the distance. So he gets in his car and gets the fuck out of there. Cut to the next day at the doctor's office. Will's given a rabies shot, but I'm not too sure if that covers werewolf bites now, does it?
And to answer your question, it was a wolf that was staring straight at it. You don't confuse a dog with a wolf.
I see, whatever you say.
So Will is an editor at a publishing house, but when a new company takes over, Will pretty much gets demoted, and if that's not enough, he's humiliated at a party by the evil business owner, millionaire asshole, Raymond Alden.
Then my area will no longer be editor-in-chief of McLeish House after the takeover.
Look, it's nothing personal. Come on, you know.
He literally gives this man's job to his assistant. Now that's some low-ass, scummy shit right there.
You're a nice person, Will. Thank God I replaced you. And I hope you give Eastern Europe a shot.
Then out of nowhere, all the horses start to flip out, like they can sense the monster within Will or something. Hell is happening to you, Will? You good, man? This is where we meet Laura Alden, played by the sexy, legendary Michelle Pfeiffer.
Finished your drink.
What are you, the last civilized man?
Turns out Laura here is the daughter of the rich asshole Raymond Alden.
He just fired you, didn't he?
Demoted, I think, is the word. I've been offered a choice between no job and a job no one wants.
And she basically falls for Will, not knowing that he is a quote-unquote werewolf. After sleeping all day, eating like a slob, Will gets extra horny. After delivering the wolf dick, he goes to jump in the shower when he notices a bunch of thick, coarse hair growing from the wound. What the fuck is happening to you, man? The next day at work, Will starts to realize that his senses are extremely heightened.
Don't you do get contacts?
I'll be damned.
This man is hearing people all the way in the bathroom and shit.
That's official. Will Randall's out, Stuart Swinton's in.
I can't take it anymore.
Now that would be fucking intense. Later that night, Will arrives home when his wolf powers kick in, and he picks up a strange scent on his wife's clothes, I'm guessing, and sets out into the night, only to find his wife shacked the fuck up with his assistant. Damn. Those fucking snakes, huh? Stewart's weasel ass tries to apologize pretty much when Will gives him a firm but fair warning.
I'm gonna get you, Stewart.
Man is scary as fuck. I would not want him pissed at me. He goes to tell Ray that he's not interested in the Eastern Europe gig and that he can shove it up his rich ass. Upon leaving, he sees Laura doing a little horseback riding. When, of course, the horse flips the fuck out and sends her ass flying.
Are you crazy? Did you
have enough brains to stay away from animals when you know they're frightened of you?
The evil rich prick comes out and tells Laura that some friends are coming over for lunch, but she informs his bitch ass that she's going out to lunch with Will.
What a pity. I'm having lunch with Will.
Karma's a bitch, ain't it, Ray? Over some good old PB&J sandwiches, they sort of get to know each other.
Is this you?
My mother. She died when I was 12.
I'm sorry.
Out on the dock, Will tells Laura about his encounter with the wolf.
Since it happened, I feel as though the wolf passed something along to me. A scrap of its spirit in my blood or something.
Suddenly, Will, starts to feel a bit under the weather. The sun goes down and the full moon comes up and turns our boy Will into a motherfucking werewolf. Yeah, it's no American Werewolf in London, but still looks pretty fucking cool. Then, cue the obligatory Wolfman chases down a deer scene. As you can see, he's really wolfing the fuck out at this point. Just like any other Wolfman flick, he wakes up with blood all over him, wondering what the fuck he's doing all the way out in the woods. He goes to pay Ray a visit, telling him that he's going to be keeping his job and pretty much how shit is going to fly around here from now on.
When I issue that press release, which I intend to do in the morning, the reputation and value of this firm will take a giant nosedive. Before I do anything, I want a deal memo granting me additional powers and additional monies, and I want it by tomorrow morning.
That's that newfound wolf confidence right there. He then goes to seek out professional help with his current lichen situation he's got going on here.
There's only one explanation for your symptoms, that you are becoming a wolf.
The doc gives him an amulet that is supposed to protect him.
One of the most powerful amulets, which must be worn next to the skin and never taken off.
Dr. Vijay then tells him that he is in fact dying and asks Will to bite him so he can become a werewolf too.
I just can't. I understand.
Under the full moon, Will awakens, and as he approaches the window, he hears the sounds of elephants and other animals, and he is instantly triggered. Flash forward to the zoo and the animals are going apeshit. Literally. Two cops approach Will because he's obviously the cause of all the ruckus going on here when he makes a break for it and bolts out of there.
Did you see that?
Down an alley, he runs into the local thugs, and then this happens.
Shit! Shit!
The next day in the pisser, he fires that little babe-stealing fuck and literally pisses all over his shoes.
This is fucking rude. What, are you crazy?
No. Just marking my territory.
His slut ex begs him to take her back, but he tells her cheating ass where the fuck to go.
Don't be such a smug.
Don't touch me. And keep away.
Laura comes by to talk to him, but he's currently turning into a werewolf, and now just isn't a good time.
Something else.
To the wolf.
So after she frees Will from the cuffs, they, of course, get it on. So wait a minute, Does that mean that she's one now, too, or... I mean, the doctor said... Will then sets out to howl underneath the moonlight, sending all the nearby animals into an uproar. Returning in time to crawl right back into bed with his chick unnoticed. Dude is slick. The dad from Step Brothers shows up. Only this time, he's a detective, and he informs Will that his wife has been brutally murdered.
She was murdered sometime late last night. Her body was found in the park.
He wants to know where Will was last night when all the murder went down.
Mr. Randall was with me last night. All night. I arrived at 6:30 and I didn't leave. You can check that with the desk.
After throwing the detectives off their trail...
Got an alibi.
They pull up to a guard post outside the manor, and Will tells Laura to lock him up in the car because he has his lucky amulet and is sure that he can beat this lycanthropy bullshit. She rushes inside and gets a phone call from the detective saying that the DNA was a match to that of a wolf, and this is where she makes a shocking realization.
Canine DNA found in all of the tissue samples.
So that could mean that the victim was attacked by some kind of animal after she was killed.
Oh, fuck. He wasn't talking crazy. This dude is a werewolf. Holy shit. After he confesses his love to her,
I've never loved anybody this way.
She locks him up in a barn right next to all the horses who are just dying to see him. But even though she may love him as well, she knows what must be done. Over the barn, Will's beginning his transformation. Aw, shit. It's about to go down. Oh, and did I forget to mention that Stuart? Yeah, you know that double-crossing little snake fuck? Well, he's also a werewolf now. Stuart's little bitch wolf ass basically goes to the station to rat Will out.
He was like a madman. He was a madman. He bit me, actually. He urinated on my shoe. Urinated.
The wolf rat finds out that Laura has left and is hot on her trail. So you know what's about to go down now? There's about to be a motherfucking wolf fight. Stuart pulls up to the gate, and when the guard won't let him in, he rams that sumbitch. Oh, and he needlessly attacks this poor security guard who was just making his rounds. Even as a werewolf, this dude is a dick. Weredick shows up and starts uncomfortably licking Laura when she hits his thirsty ass with a fire extinguisher, totally burning his eyeballs. After a little wolf and mouse, Will fully wolfs the fuck out, and then the moment you've all been waiting for, werewolf fight! After a really badass werewolf showdown, Weredick decides to pull one final scare, but just gets shot the fuck down by Laura. Yeah, take that, you fucking werewolf dick. Will faces the harsh reality, knowing that he can never really be with Laura, you know, his one and only true love, and runs off into the night. The cops show up and ask Laura if she knows where Will went, but she just plays dumb with them and walks away. We find out that Will did in fact turn her into a werewolf after all. And that's pretty much the end of the movie. I definitely highly recommend that you guys check this one out. If you're a Jack Nicholson and a werewolf fan, you definitely gotta see this. It has that basic werewolf movie formula, but just the fact that it's Jack Nicholson as a creature of the night makes it all the better. He totally killed the role, and the way he looks as the wolf is pretty badass.
All of you.
Some truly impressive makeup effects indeed. And also, Michelle Pfeiffer and Jack Nicholson, pretty fucking awesome to see Catwoman and the Joker in the same flick, so you got that as well. And not to mention, the forbidden love story. It almost had a Beauty and the Beast sort of feel to it. What else can I really say except, go sink your teeth into this Jack Nicholson classic, Wolf. Definitely a very beastly experience. See you on the next full moon, Monster Maniacs.
Oh, that's good.